Today's Focus on Sustainability looks at a nonprofit organization that's trying to create sustainable economies in northern Arizona. Here to talk about SEDI, the Sustainable Economic Development Initiative, is its executive director, Carol Bousquet, and board member Holly Yeager, who works for Coconino County as its director of organizational development. Good to have you both here. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for joining us.
What is SEDI?
Well, SEDI consists of 45 board members plus alternates, 45 committed people who are promoting economic prosperity in northern Arizona, sustainable economic prosperity in northern Arizona.
I had a definition here, sustainable economic prosperity through ecological health, social equity, and a resilient economy.
And that's our mission statement.
Well, then what does that mean?
I would say what we're trying to do is to promote a sustainable economic environment that can be perpetuated, not one necessarily that would, land you in a place that you would have to go back. If you brought in a company that was there only because of some certain incentives, for example,
yes,
and then the economy changes and they have to leave and lay off all the people.
That's not sustainable.
And
it sounds like you've got a resilient economy, as you mentioned in your mission statement. Describe a resilient economy against just a good old-fashioned strong economy.
Sure. Well, one of the things for resilience for us in northern Arizona is it's a great place to live. And so we're always looking at how can we keep the companies that we have and how can we really promote companies that want to do the best thing for their communities. So resilience for us can look like things like having sustainability in the school system, mm-hmm. Promoting a culture of entrepreneurship, helping with local food, and promoting local food and local entrepreneurs.
It sounds like the focus is local.
That's
basically what it is. Get it here, keep it here, promote it here, grow it here.
Well, what does that mean for northern Arizona, for our environment as well as our economy?
Yeah.
And one of the unique features of the Flagstaff region is that we are not very close to other urban areas. You know, we count on transportation systems to bring goods and services, and if we can contain that, you know, provide more goods and services closer to home, that's easier to sustain.
Okay, so we mentioned keeping things local. Workforce training would help keep local workers local, correct?
Absolutely.
And you have a workforce training program?
We have been working for years on putting together a workforce training program in the region, which we anticipate being launched in January of 2013. So we're very excited about that. It's a collaboration with a host of local entities, including the community college, the university, the county, the city,
the
school district. Yeah. Thank you very much for that, because it's a facility that's utilizing a under-purposed, what is now a middle school, once was a high school, and there are empty shop spaces that are going to be renovated for that purpose.
Challenges of getting this workforce training program? Sounds like it's been a long time in coming. Have there been speed bumps? What's going on?
Well, we did a survey, mm-hmm. and so we identified that manufacturers are going to be needing a workforce training force in northern Arizona. We're expecting lots of job growth. We have all kinds of things going on, including the Four Forests Restoration Initiative, mm-hmm. The need to train lots of people in manufacturing. So what a great opportunity that we had a chance to use the existing machine floor of the former high school. Mm-hmm. And so something like this wouldn't happen without SETI, because you have government, nonprofit, and business leaders all at the table saying, how do we make the best of the resources that we have and really make the connection between the university, the workforce that we're training, and the needs of business?
And I would also add to that some of the speed bumps along the way have been questions about how would that work? How would we partner? What are the obstacles and how can we overcome those obstacles? And it's been, you know, a long and interesting process of trying to think creatively about how to come together in a cohesive fashion and make something happen.
You mentioned developing entrepreneurs up there, and I noticed on your mission site there, developing an entrepreneurial ecosystem. What does that mean?
Well, we're really excited because we're doing an event in October, on October 9th, at the High Country Conference Center, where we are going to talk about what does it take to create a culture of entrepreneurship. And there's really a role that each of us can play. As policymakers, you know, what's the role for a local government? What's the role in terms of existing entrepreneurs and ensuring their success? And then for people who are starting out from the very beginning. So we wanted to offer a range of services to entrepreneurs and future entrepreneurs, and that's what we're going to do at the summit.
Something else that looks very important for you up there, and it sounds like a wonderful opportunity, is ecotourism. It's got to be huge already in northern Arizona. How's that fitting into what you are doing?
Well, most specifically, SEDI oversees a Walton Family Foundation grant, which has provided a wonderful opportunity to partner with some other organizations in the Verde Valley and to promote ecotourism based around the preservation of the Verde River and honoring that as a destination point, but also as a resource for the area. And so that's been very interesting. And that group has also then in turn connected. There's a website that connects with the Flagstaff area Green Business Network, and together the synergy has provided a rich ecotourism resource.
I've heard collaboration. I've heard synergy. it sounds like a lot of folks are. It sounds like folks are getting together. Are they getting together? Is it kind of hard? Is it a little bit of herding cats up there? How's it working so far?
Not really. We have a lot of leaders in Northern Arizona, a lot of people who are really committed to the sustainability of the region, people from every sector really coming together. SEDI is very unique in that it brings these groups together and really asks, you know, what's possible. We take a longer term focus. So sometimes we create almost the fertile ground for economic development efforts, and we partner with a very long list of folks working on economic development. And sometimes what we do is very simple. We've had a very successful teacher recognition award, and it's just phenomenal to be able to recognize 4 teachers a year for what they do to integrate sustainability into their curriculum.
And in fact, I think we're going to build on that as well with bringing businesses and the students, our future leaders, together to partner on sustainability efforts.
I saw one thing that was fascinating, the idea of keeping food production and food security local, and a regional beef processing plant is being considered. What is that all about?
Well, you know, we've sponsored some studies to ascertain whether or not there's really a market for it. I mean, one thing we've got a lot of in Northern Arizona is cattle, right? All right, so it doesn't seem like a real sustainable practice to ship it to the Midwest to be processed and then ship it back to sell it in the grocery store. And so what we're trying to figure out is what are the obstacles to keeping that local? And it turns out that USDA inspection is one of them. And so, you know, SEDI have brought in USDA inspectors and said, okay, here are some processing plants in the area, small ones, albeit, but a start. And what is it that they can do to upgrade their facilities so that you would come in and do the inspections necessary to make that it possible for them to sell it locally? And we have found one gentleman who is right now working to upgrade his facilities for just that purpose. And like I said, small, but an incremental start.
And local. I kind of asked you this in a different way, but I want to ask you again. Just basically the response. The response from civic leaders, the response from business leaders, the response from residents. What are you hearing?
I think that we're a very progressive community, and there's a lot of excitement about economic development and economic prosperity in Northern Arizona. So I think that SEDI is very much part of that, and everybody sees that they have a unique role to play. And it's great to be part of an organization where you can hear directly from business about what makes our community so unique and how do we make sure that we preserve those things as we go into the future.
What are you hearing, again, from civic, business, and just folks?
I think there's a lot of enthusiasm for the future of the region, and I think people are coming together. I hear lots of partnerships taking place. In fact, one of the things that SEDI has been increasing our partnership with the Verde Valley. We're holding board meetings on occasion down there. We have board members from Clarkdale and Camp Verde and Sedona. And to bring that perspective and energy into the conversation has just been really invigorating.
All right. Well, it sounds like things are happening up there. Good luck and continued good success.
Come see us.
All right. Are you kidding me?
It's almost August.
We're on the road already. Goodness.